well met, friend. See you then.
You, those are Elwyn's. By the flames, you're his firstborn, Clive Rosfield.
You're mistaken.
Oh, you can't fool me, my lord. You're the very image of your father, and that would be true even if you weren't wearing his clothes. The selfsame garments Hannah was keeping for you, if I'm not mistaken. She always swore that she would never part with them until the day Elwyn's sons returned. And now that day has come. Why, you'll be able to take your bearers back as well.
My bearers? Forgive me, Master Mayor. I was a child when last I came to Eastpool. I didn't recognize you.
Oh, I'd be surprised if you recognized anything at all. Much has changed since Rosaria fell to the Empire. Not least for the bearers who once served her noble families. When the Ironblood sacked Rosalith 13 years back, many who lost their masters fled here, in search of sanctuary.
And never returned.
Aye. The plan was to send them home once we'd won back the capital. But then the Imperials arrived. Rosaria became a province of Sanbrec. The duchy was dissolved, and they no longer had any home to return to. Back in your father's day, any bearer who lost their master became a ward of the duchy. We'd hand them over to the sheriffs, and they'd be assigned a new position. But when we saw how the Empire treated their branded, we knew that wasn't an option. So they've been here ever since.
And now you want to give them to me?
They're yours by right, Lord Rosfield. Bequeathed you by your late father. And they'd be better off serving you than hiding here. Indeed, many of them used to serve your house, and still consider the Rosfields their masters.
I'm no one's master. Not anymore. They wouldn't be safe with me.
I understand. You'll forgive an old man his fanciful notions. Been daydreaming for too long. But still, I would ask a favor of you. A small mercy.
If it is within my power.
One of the bearers is an elderly fellow who still swears absolute loyalty to Archduke Elwyn. I don't ask that you take him into your service, only that you meet with him. Let him see that Elwyn's son still lives, and that he's as fine a man as his father ever was.
It would be my honor.
Thank you, my lord. He sits by the well most days, watching the people go about their business. If you could show him your face, I would be most grateful.
As fine a man as my father.
You're not so very different, you know. Especially dressed like that. Come on, let's go and meet that bearer.
Sure, this is.
He's not here.
Well, I can't leave without meeting him. I've let the mayor down once already. It would be cruel to disappoint him again.
Right, let's ask around. Someone must have seen him.
What?
We're looking for an elderly...
Ah, you mean the old boy?
Yes.
What business do you have with him?
If you don't... We are, in a way.
Well then, it's a pleasure to meet a fellow Rosalithian. I was born and raised down...
And never would have left if Archduke Elwyn had survived the fire. It wasn't the same when the Duchess took over, though. All the beatings, the evictions, the levies going up and up and up. Oh, listen to me.
I'm afraid I can...
Well...
Good day, m'lady.
I'm looking for a bearer.
Ah, Hey, hold on a mo. Young Patrick, the chocobo keeper, might know where he is. He's taken the old bird under his wing, so to speak. He'll be in the stables.
Patrick, the chocobo keeper.
I'm sorry, Jill, for making you do all this in my stead.
It can't be helped if we're to keep up the pretense. Come on, let's head for the stables. Excuse me.
It's this bearer I've been minding. I take my eye, he's not in his usual spot by the...
You must be Patrick.
I am.
And this bearer you're looking for.
That's the fella. How do you know all this? I've never seen you in Eastpool before, but you seem to know the place better than I do myself. So that's out. Well then, if you're acting under orders of the mayor, you're on a bound to help me find him. He's been losing what little sense he had left of late, saying the sheriffs are coming to collect him, and I was supposed to watch.
Understood.
Thank you.
I hope he hasn't wandered into trouble.
Let's just concentrate on finding him. Still no sign. Could he have strayed even further? Look, there's someone over there.
It might be him. We should hurry.
We can't lead them to the old man. They need to die.
Agreed.
There, boy! Get off! Sick of trouble! Don't let them get away!
Are you all right, my friend? Come on. Let's go home.
Your Grace! You came for me! I waited for you so long, but you finally came!
I'm... not who you think.
Clive.
Yes. Pray forgive my long delay.
It's nothing, Your Grace. I prayed to the Founder that you would come. And at long last, he answered. Will we be returning to the castle then? There is still a place for me in the kitchens?
No, my friend. We will not be returning to the castle, not yet. I'm on a very important expedition. One which may take some time. Could you wait for me in Eastpool until my journey is complete? I will come back for you then. I promise.
Of course, Your Grace. For you, I would gladly wait until my dying day.
Thank you, both of you. You've been most... The memory of serving the late Archduke was his one light in the darkness. And now that light burns a little more brightly. It's nothing but a fantasy, of course. But it's better than the truth of the matter. A damn sight better. The blight is on our doorstep. If it weren't for Lady Hannah's... We want...
Is it really that bad?
So bad. I even petitioned the Imperial Garrison to take them. But when they found out where they'd come from, they damn near spat in our faces. Ducal dog.
I know a man named Cid, who would gladly give a home to any bearer in need. Leave this with me. As soon as I return from Phoenix Gate.
Thank you. Will you be passing through Eastpool on your way back? I should very much like to speak with you again. If you have... regarding the future...
Yes, of course.
Fare you well.
Deadlands are aptly named.
I didn't realize they were this close.
No wonder their crops are failing. The blight is leaching the ether from the soil. And when the last drop is drained, their fields will turn to this. No plants. No animals. No life.
And no monsters. I suppose that's one small mercy.
We won't be able to use any magic here.
Another thing to worry about. As if the absence of ether didn't cause enough problems.
Take away the lad's life force, and problems are all that's left.
I can hardly imagine what this place used to look like before the blight took it.
I remember. It was beautiful.
Come on, Clive. It's time to discover the truth.
almost as if time had stood still.
I suppose no one had any cause to return here. No. It's just as I left it. Have a look around. Could I have done this?
Could anyone? What is it, Torgal? Clive.
That's him. He's the only one who can tell me what happened. I have to know. Where is he?
Nowhere to be seen.
Damn it! He's like a bloody eel.
What is this place, anyway? Some sort of shrine?
Oh, sorry. You've never been here before. This is the Hall of the Gate.
The Gate?
It's a relic of the Fallen. Only the Phoenix's dominant can open it.
Hence the castle's name. This was where Joshua was supposed to...
Yes. He would have stepped through this door the next morning and listened to the words of our ancestors.
Would you have gone with him?
No. The Appoditary is holy ground. None but the Dominant may enter. I and the other shields would have stood guard here and prayed for my brother's safe return. Where the hell did he go?
Perhaps he went inside.
He couldn't have. He'd need the power of the Phoenix.
Are you sure about this?
Nevermore. Another gate. Let's see if this one opens.
hardly call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell.
Sick of Toggle.
Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep looking.
Keep your distance, boy. Get him. You know what to do.
like this.
Seems the feeling's mutual.
It's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is. right then.
This place holds even more secrets than we thought. Here.
Another fallen wonder.
Something.
So, it isn't a dead end after all.
Apparently not.
Room.
And look what's in it. How old do you suppose this is? 1,000 years? More?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it before. Who is that in the middle, do you think? Some sort of god.
You're him. The second Dominant of Fire. Who are you?
Joshua chose me to be his shield. He gave me his blessing and asked me to keep him safe. I should have protected him that day. It was my duty. Joshua died. I killed him.
And I blamed another for what I did. To spare myself the guilt. I feared that by accepting it, I would lose what little was left of me. So I ran. From everything.
And now? Are you ready to accept the truth?
I am. I know it won't be easy, but it's
what I must do so that Joshua's soul can finally rest in peace.
Ah! escape, eh? It's all right. I'm done running from you. Together, then. It's time to find out who we are, once and for all.